Everyone, welcome to agriculture vidya. Welcome to agriculture vidya. Today I will explain about major national programs for achieving doubling farmers income. Those are Pradhan Mantri Krishi Sanchayi Yojana, PMKSY, Pradhan Mantri Gram Sadak Yojana, PMGSY, Electronic National Agriculture Market ENAM, ప్రధానమంత్రి ఫసల్ బీమా యోజన, పిఎంఎఫ్బివై, పరంపరాగత్ కృషి వికాస్ యోజన, పికేవివై. లెట్ ఐ విల్ ఎక్స్ప్లెయిన్ వన్ బై వన్. నెక్స్ట్, ఫస్ట్ వన్ ఈస్ ప్రధానమంత్రి కృషి సంచాయి యోజన, పిఎంకేఎస్వై. Government of India is committed to accord high priority to water conservation and its management. Government has given high priority to water conservation and its management. To this effect, Pradhan Mantri Krishi Sanchayi Yojana has been formulated. The scheme has been formulated with the vision of extending the coverage of irrigation. Or कहते तो पानी and improving water use efficiency, more crop per drop. In a focused manner with end-to-end solutions. On source creation, distribution, management, field application and extension activities. The Cabinet Committee on Economic Affairs, chaired by Honorable Prime Minister, has accorded approval of this scheme, that is Pradhan Mantri Krishi Sanchayi Yojana, in meeting held on July 1, 2015. This scheme, Pradhan Mantri Krishi Sanchayi Yojana, has been formulated amalgamating ongoing schemes, namely Accelerated Irrigation Benefit Program, AIBP, of the Ministry of Water Resources, River Development, Ganga Rejuvenation, that is MOWR, RD and GR, Integrated Watershed Management Program, IWMP, of Department of Land Resources, that is DOLR, and on the On-Farm Water Management, OFWM, of Department of Agriculture and Cooperation, DAC, DAC. This scheme has been approved for implementation throughout the country, across the country, with an outlay of 50,000 crore rupees, that is for 5 years, in 5 years. Achievement of this program, that is in the year 2016-17, whereas micro irrigation potential protected on 8,39,965 hectares. Next national program is Pradhan Mantri Gram Sadak Yojana, PMGSY. It was launched on December 25th, 2000 as a fully funded centrally sponsored scheme useful to provide all weather road connectivity in rural areas of the country. This program envisages connecting all habitations with a population of 500 persons and above, that is in plain areas, whereas 250% and above in hill states. 250% and above in hill states, in tribal and desert areas. Rural road connectivity is the key component of rural development. This scheme promotes access to economic and social services and generates increased agricultural income. To increase the agriculture income and productive employment. road connectivity is a key ingredient, which is useful to ensure sustainable poverty reduction. Useful to ensure sustainable poverty reduction. Achievement of this program. About 4.54 lakh kilometer roads completed in the country. Third one is Electronic National Agriculture Market, ENAM. It is a pan-India electronic trading portal launched by Ministry of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare, Government of India. It is useful to facilitate farmers, traders, buyers, exporters, processors with a common platform for trading commodities. This program currently links 250 APMCs, that is agriculture produce marketing committees from across 10 states. This portal is managed by Small Farmers Agribusiness Consortium, SFAC, appointed by the ministry and association with a group of strategic farmers selected for this purpose. In this, traders and exporters need to register themselves. With the portal to access its services. 69 commodities. Those are staple food grains, vegetables, and fruits. What are the objectives of ENAM? Unified market through online trading platform, both at state level and national level. To remove information asymmetry, that is between buyers and sellers, and promotes real-time price discovery, which is based on actual demand and supply, to promote transparency in auction process, to assess to national wide market for farmer and online payment for farmer, national wide market and online payment for farmer, and availability of better quality produce at market at more reasonable prices. Availability of better quality produce at more reasonable prices to the consumer. Farmer is the seller, consumer is the buyer. Achievements. ENAM currently links 250 APMCs, that is Agriculture Produce Marketing Committees, from across 10 states. The portal is managed by Small Farmers Agribusiness Consortium, SFAC. Next one is Pradhan Mantri Fasal Bima Yojana. It is a new crop insurance scheme in line with One Nation, One Scheme theme. It is based on One Nation, One Scheme theme. It incorporates all features of previous schemes at the same time. All good features of previous schemes. Whereas previous weaknesses or shortcomings are removed. And good features are incorporated. This scheme will replace the existing two schemes. Those are National Agricultural Insurance Scheme, NAIS, and Modified NAIS, National Agriculture Insurance Scheme. Objectives of PMFBY. It is useful to provide insurance coverage and financial support to farmers. At the time of crop failure as a result of natural calamities, pests and diseases. Useful to stabilize the farmer's income, thereby ensuring their continuity in farming. To encourage the farmers to adopt innovative and modern agricultural practices. To ensure flow of credit to agriculture sector. this scheme covers Pradhan Mantri Fasal Bima Yojana scheme covers Kharif, Rabi, annual commercial and horticulture crops. For Kharif crops, the farmer's part of premium is 2% of sum assured. In case of Rabi crops, that is the part of premium is 1.5% of the sum assured. In case of annual commercial and horticulture crops, the part of premium is 5% of the sum assured. Last one is Paramparagat Krushi Vikasa Yojana, PKVY. PKVY is an elaborated component of Soil Health Management SHM project, that is National Mission on Sustainable Agriculture. National Mission of Sustainable Agriculture. Under PKVY scheme, under this scheme, organic farming is promoted through adoption of organic village by cluster approach and PGS certification. The scheme envisages Paramparagat scheme envisages promotion of commercial organic production through certified organic farming. The produce will be pesticide residue free. So it will improve the health of the consumer. It will raise the farmer's income and create potential market for traders. It will motivate the farmers for natural resource mobilization for input production. Under this scheme, groups of the farmers would be motivated to take up organic farming. That is, 50 or more farmers will form a cluster. 50 or more farmers will form a cluster having 50 acres of the land under this scheme to take up organic farming. In this way, during 3 years, 10,000 clusters are formed covering 5 lakh acre area under organic farming. There will be no liability on farmers for expenditure on certification. Each farmer or every farmer will be provided with 20,000 rupees per acre, that is in 3 years from seed to harvesting of crops and transport the produce to the market. Organic farming will be promoted in this scheme. Organic farming will be promoted by using traditional resources, and this organic product will be linked with the market. It will increase domestic production and certification of organic produce by involving farmers. Thank you. If you like this video, please share and subscribe. Don't forget to comment also. To watch it again, please click on this below link. Thank you.